I'm with Live Clean Canada.
Good afternoon. My name is Rich Krohovich. Company is Call Rich Eco Services.
My name is Tara Story. I'm with Oshawa PUC Networks.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jeff Watson. I'm representing Gentech Building Products.
My name is Steve Snyder. I'm with Ontario ICF Supply.
My name is Norrie McLeod. I'm with a company called Willis Supply from Burlington, Ontario.
My name is Charlie Slack. I'm the owner of Sunshade Blinds and Drapery in Pickering Village.
My name is Jim Gaylor. I work for Yanch Heating Air Conditioning. We've been in business since 1965.
I'm Joan Kerr, and I'm the director of Foundation for Building Sustainable Communities.
I'm Pierre Heinz. I'm here with the German Electric Vehicle Association.
Hello, my name is Karen. I'm with Friends of the Earth. We're a nonprofit environmental organization.
My name is Derek Kelly, and I'm with Thermapan Structural Insulated Panels.
My name is John St. John. I work with Southern Exposure Systems.
My name is Chris Lofopito. I'm a president and CEO of the Cup Gold Trading Company Limited.
Hi, my name is Jason Carter, and I'm the founder and president of the Durham E-Bike Association.
John Gray, mayor of Oshawa.
Hello, my name is Chad Pescott, and I have a used building supply store called EnviroSponsible in Whitby, Ontario.
Hi, my name is Dave Renault. I'm president of the CAW Durham Region Environmental Council. We represent over 33,500 members.
My name is Peter Love. I'm proud to be Ontario's first Chief Energy Conservation Officer, and I work with an organization called the Ontario Power Authority, and I'm going to answer a few questions that some of you may have.
My name is Suzanne Elston. I'm the Senior Environmental Coordinator for the City of Oshawa.
One of our mandates, which is to preserve and restore the environment, and what better way to do that than to save and be energy efficient? My tip for today is, amongst many, is to plan what you want out of the refrigerator. If you place contents in the fridge so that you know where they are, so you do not have to open the fridge door for very long, you will save a lot of energy.
Well, in my own home, I've converted all my lights to the, replaced the incandescent bulb with the compact fluorescence. And, you know, we try and instill with the kids, turn off the lights. If you leave your room, turn off the television. It's the same old thing that happens in all families, I think. But we try and encourage conservation at home, and we always tell them the advantage to it, of course, is that there's more money for vacation.
At the City of Oshawa, we're learning to walk the talk. We did an energy retrofit of City Hall, which is not only saving about $500,000 a year in energy costs, it's reduced our greenhouse gas emissions by over 50%. Energy tips for homeowners. What most people don't realize is more than 60%, close to two-thirds of the energy that is used in the municipal infrastructure is actually used to pump water. So by doing things like installing low-flow showerheads and low-flow toilets, you're not only saving water, you're also saving a tremendous amount of energy.
We're a community group, and we're a few people who are interested in electrical vehicles. We concentrate mainly on helping each other. We run conferences, we run training courses, and a few of us even own electric cars. Our main objective is to weed off dead dinosaurs. We don't like using oil in cars. Electricity is a much more efficient way of getting energy into a motor than the diesel oil. My tip for our homeowners, drive the speed limit. Never go over the speed limit, and you'll save a lot of fuel that way.
We're an association located strictly in Durham, and since October 2006, electric bicycles have been legal in Ontario. Our goal is to promote these bicycles as a viable part of the future transportation mix. And so these bikes generally get between 45 and 50 kilometers on one charge, and one charge costs about 9 to 10 cents of hydroelectricity.
Friends of the Earth is working on climate change, one of the areas that we're working on is the Energy Green Box. The box is full of energy conservation devices to help low-income families reduce their energy use.
Well, our tip for the homeowner today is to help us with some of our campaigns in regards to green car policies, climate change, Kyoto Accord. Our main mandate is to go after environmental issues in the community and to look after our members.
We're a Canadian corporation, and we're dedicated to helping individuals and businesses reduce their carbon footprint. Basically what we do is we help individuals understand what their carbon emissions are. Carbon emissions are basically the pollution that's created when you heat your home, light your home, drive, fly, run your business. So we help individuals and companies assess their footprint.
Today I'm actually just introducing a new siding product that we've just launched this year. This is a Prodigy siding. It actually comes with an insulation backer. As you can see here, it's a D6 profile, and it's got an insulation backer. This insulation actually is molded to the siding itself and gives you a high energy value of an R6 rating.
We've done energy systems, both hot water systems and photovoltaics, since 2003. The tip for the homeowner would be to install these hot water heating systems to subsidize and the existing hot water and to eliminate the cost and the energy that's required to heat their domestic hot water.
We have a series of photoluminescent signage that uses absolutely no hydro whatsoever and is maintenance free.
We sell very energy efficient window coverings. The windows themselves are the weak spot in any home, and we can increase the insulation value of the windows by about 200% of certain shade systems. Use your window coverings properly. During the daytime in the winter, you want to have them open to let the light in, but in the summertime, the sun's coming in, you want to close those shades to keep the heat out.
We specialize in comfortable, energy efficient, and healthy homes and buildings. And one of our specialties is the building envelope, in other words, insulation. One of the products that we use a lot of is, you've been hearing a lot more about it, is spray foam insulation. It can be sprayed virtually anywhere, and it creates an airtight, watertight, super insulated envelope wherever that might be.
I find that insulated concrete forms are probably the most energy efficient exterior wall system on the market today. The reason for that is, I'll show you a form right here. You have 2 5/8 EPS foam on the exterior and on the interior, and you put rebar horizontal and vertical. You pour concrete in there, so the performance of the wall would perform between R40, R50. Therefore, you can downsize your heating and cooling equipment. It should save you between 50 to 70% on your energy costs.
We're a big supporter of anything to do with energy conservation, and Geotherm being the most efficient system known to man today. I think I would advise anyone that are building a home to ask their builder about Geotherm systems and proceed from there.
I have a used building supply store in Whitby, Ontario called EnviroSponsible. I divert usable items from the landfill, like windows, doors, flooring, and offer them to the public at reduced prices.
A structural insulated panel is an alternative way to build a new home. Instead of using 2x6s and fiberglass insulation with a vapor barrier and an air barrier, this replaces that, and it gives you a far more energy efficient, thermally effective, airtight structure than what you get if you'd done it conventionally.
Our company is a company that is designed to save the average homeowner, business owner, money on their heating and cooling costs through solar heating products.
Oshawa PUC Networks provides Oshawa residents with electricity. We're the distribution company, and our tip to save electricity or use electricity more efficiently is just to turn electrical items off when you're not using them and don't waste.
The question is, what is energy conservation and what are the benefits? There's four basic types of conservation. The first and most important, far as I'm concerned, is conservation behavior. Finding the light switch, turning it off, using a programmable thermostat, turning off a computer when you're not using it, using a power bar. Doesn't cost you a cent, just use less.